हेलो, आई एम डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी माओ, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जूलॉजी, श्री सांवलिया जी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, मंडफिया, चित्तौड़गढ़। टुडे माय टॉपिक इज प्रोटोकॉर्डेटा, कैरेक्टर्स एंड क्लासिफिकेशन। व्हाट आर प्रोटोकॉर्डेट्स? प्रोटोकॉर्डेट्स आर लोअर प्रिमिटिव कॉर्डेट्स। दे आर ऑफ वेरी लिटिल इकोनॉमिक इम्पॉर्टेंस, बट दे हैव अ ग्रेट फाइलोजेनेटिक सिग्निफिकेंस टू अस। They show great affinities and perhaps common origin with living vertebrates. They have all the three basic features throughout life, that is notochord, holodorsal nerve cord and pharyngeal gill slits. They are considered most primitive and borderline chordates, closer to the ancestor, which probably give rise to the final and the largest group of chordates, the vertebrates. The earlier arrangement of recognizing the taxonomic status of phylum Protochordata has been given up nowadays because the three subphyla do not show any intimate relationship. Yeah, they have all the three fundamental or primitive chordate characteristics, but they differ from one another in several ways. Now, characteristics of protochordates. Protochordates, they are generally found in marine water, means they are exclusively marine. Their body is bilaterally symmetrical. They are triploblastic. Their coelom is enterocoelic, that is budding off from embryonic archenteron. At certain stages of their lives, they develop a long rod-like structure called notochord. They don't have skull, cranium and vertebral column. Heart chamberless when present and no red blood capsules in blood. Their kidneys protonephrite and they have organ system level of organization. And development is indirect with the free living larval stages. Now we will see its classification. Protochordata is divided into three subphylum, that is Hemichordata, Urochordata and Cephalochordata. Hemichordata are also known as half chordate. Urochordata has tail coat and Cephalochordata is also known as head coat. First of all, we will see Hemichordata subphylum. They are exclusively marine, solitary or colonial and mostly tuberculous. They have a soft, fragile, vermiform, unsegmented, bilaterally symmetrical and triploblastic body. Their body is divided into three distinct regions, that is proboscis, collar and trunk. Their body wall is single layered, epidermis with mucous gland. They don't have dermis. Their coelom is enterocoelous and it is usually divided into protocoel, mesocoel and metacoel. The digestive tube complete, straight or U-shaped. Their foregut gives out a hollow buccal diverticulum into proboscis, which was earlier considered as notochord. They have a dorsal lateral pharyngeal gill slits when present and they are one to several pairs and they are ciliary filter feeders. Their circulatory system is simple and open, which comprises of heart with two longitudinal vessels. Heart is dorsal, but longitudinal vessel, one is dorsal and another is ventral. Excretion by a single proboscis gland or glomerulus connected to blood vessels. They have primitive nervous system which consists of mainly of a subepidermal nerve, plexus, dorsal collar nerve cord is hollow. Now, reproduction, mainly sexual. Sexes are separate, gonads, one to several pairs. Fertilization is either internal or external. And development direct or indirect with a free swimming Tornaria larva. Example is Cephalodiscus and Rhabdopleura. Now, Hemichordata is divided into four classes: Anthropneusta, Pterobranchia, Planctospheroida, and Graptolita. Anthropneusta, solitary, free swimming, and burrowing animals, and they are commonly known as acorn or tongue worms. Their body is elongated, vermiform, with no stalk. Proboscis is cylindrical and tapering. Example of Anthropneusta class is Balanoglossus and Psychoglossus. Now, class Protobranchia, they are also solitary or colonial, sessile, and tuberculous animal. They live inside secreted chitinous tubes. Their body is short, compact, and with a stalk for attachment. Their proboscis is shield-like. They have two orders, Rhabdopleurida and Cephalodiscida. Rhabdopleurida are colonial joids which are connected by a stolon. They have a collar with two tentaculated arms and they don't have gill slits. Example is Rhabdopleura. Now, order Cephalodiscida. They are solitary and several joints living unconnected in a common gelatinous case. They have collar with a several tentaculated arms, single pair of gill slits, and gonads, single pair. Example is Cephalodiscus. Now, class 3, Planctosporidia. It is represented by a very few small, rounded, transparent, and pelagic larva. They are supposed to be specialized Tornaria of some unknown Hemichordata. Now, Graptolita. They are the fossils. And they were very abundant in Ordovician and Silurian periods. And they are now considered as an extinct class under Hemichordata. Now, Urochordata. Urochordata are marine, sessile, and filter feeders. Mostly sedentary, some pelagic and free swimming. They are also known as tunicates, because their body is surrounded by a leathery sheath composed of tunicin, which is a kind of cellulose. Their adult body degenerate, sac-like, unsegmented, without paired appendages, and usually without tail. Notochord appears in the larval stage in the tail of the larva, but it disappears in the adult. This process is also known as retrogressive metamorphosis. Neural tube in the larva is replaced by dorsal ganglion in the adults. They respire through gills. They have open circulatory system. They don't have excretory organs. They reproduce asexually by budding, excretion by neural gland, pyloric gland, and nephrocytes. They are mostly hermaphrodite, and fertilization is cross and external. Development is indirect, which includes a free swimming tail larva with basic coded characters, and asexual reproduction by budding. Example is Herdmania. Now, Urochordata सब फाइलम इज डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री क्लासेस, दैट इज एसिडेसी, थेलिएसी एंड लार्वेसी. एसिडेसी आर सॉलिटरी, कॉलोनियल, बॉटम लिविंग. बॉडी फॉर्म एंड साइज इज वेरिएबल. दे हैव अ परमानेंट टेस्ट विच इज़ वेल डेवलप्ड एंड थिक. दे हैव अ एट्रियम, ओपन्स डोर्सली बाय एट्रियम. Their pharynx is large with many persistent gill slits. Larva is free-swimming and highly developed. Adult usually sessile after retrograde metamorphosis when larval notochord, nerve cord and tail are lost and brain reduced to a solid dorsal ganglion. Acidiaceae class has two orders, Antrogona and Pleurogona. Antrogona have body which is divided into thorax and abdomen and neural gland usually ventral to ganglion. Example of Antrogona is Acidia sciona. Now Pleurogona order, their body is compact and undivided, neural gland dorsal or lateral to ganglion. Example is Herdmannia. Now class Thaliaceae. They are adult, free-living, pelagic in warm and temperate seas. They are solitary or colonial. Their body shape and size is variable. Tunicin is permanent, thin and transparent with circular muscle bands. Their atropore is located posteriorly. They have a pharynx with two large or many gill slits. Adult is without notochord, nerve cord and tail. Example of Thaliaceae is Pyrosoma. Now Thaliaceae is divided into three orders, Pyrosomidae, Doliidae and Sulfida. Now Pyrosomida, their colony is compact, tubular, closed at one end, joints embedded in a common test. Muscle band confined to body ends. Gill slits tall, numerous, up to 50 in number. No free seeming larval stage is present in it. Example is Pyrosoma. Now Doliolida. Their body is barrel shaped. Muscle bands form 8 complete rings. Gill slits small, few to many. A tail larva with notochord present in it. Example is Doliolum. Now Sulfida. Their body is cylindrical or prism shaped. Muscle band incomplete ventrally. Pharynx communicates freely with atrium through a large gill slit and tail larva is absent. Example is Sulfa. Now class Larvaceae. They are small, solitary, free-swimming, pelagic, neotenic. Their test form a temporary house, renewed periodically. In them, atrium as well as atrial aperture absent. Gill slits are two, open directly to outside. They have a two order, Endostylophora and Polystylophora. Endostylophora, they have a pharynx with endostyle. And Polystylophora, they have a pharynx without endostyle. Example of Endostylophora is Oikopleura. An example of Polystylophora is Koala viscia. Now Cephalochordata. Cephalochordata are marine and filter feeder. Their notochords remain throughout life and extends up to the head region. Nerve cord and the tail also remain throughout life. They have excretory organs which are known as solenocysts. They respire through gills which open in the atrium. Their body wall comprises of amphioxus. Digestive tract कंप्लीट, फेरिंग्स लार्ज परफोरेटेड बाय न्यूमरस परसिस्टेंट गिल स्लिट्स विच ओपन इनटू एट्रियम एज आई टोल्ड यू बिफोर. एग्जाम्पल इज एम्फियोक्सिस. सिफिलोकॉर्डेटा हैज ओनली वन क्लास, दैट इज अ लैप्टोकार्डी, एंड दे हैव अ सेम कैरेक्टर इज एज ऑफ सिफिलोकॉर्डेटा. थैंक यू.